Question.
Gathered and shaped this bubble out,
put a lot of emphasis on where the thickness, the thickened areas were throughout the cheeks. And where the chin will be. And then I flatten both sides. And it gives a little bit of a predetermined shape to where the jawline will be. Sides flat, and the narrower sides of the face and the wider sides can be the back of the head.
You do you, baby. I'll do my best to keep up.
I'm like, one trick that I would definitely like to share, topic, whatever, is that I want to see exactly where my heat was on the inside. It's not always that easy to do that with Silver Strike 5. So a lot of times I like to go right up next to the light bulb and like really get the spot. Usually I chill it and then move it. So then it's, you know, it's not worse than ever, but the light has a big glow. You can also look for the hottest glow on the inside of the glass. Right now I'm getting upper lip nice and strong here, stiff upper lip. It does kind of help not look at it. it helps move a large amount of glass rather than it stuck in one spot too. While that sets up, it's actually going to stay hot a lot longer than I want to wait. And I kind of flame and kneel that down while I do the cheeks. That helps keep everything moving along, and it actually helps kind of set up the overall alignment pretty well too. So I put the cheekbone right at the, it's on the opposite side, but right at the apex of like where the flattened area is and around through the meat. Thank you. decent layout to the cheekbones. Mouth is always exaggerated because I'm going to cut into that. You know, when you carve into tubing, it can move pretty damn fast. So it's one of the most interesting things to explore with sculpting on a knife. It goes quick and I blow in, and I blow into the tubing while I carve that.
Thank you.
define a shape with the larger size ball, and then I'll step down to the smaller size to do the final detail. Usually it's just two sizes, you know, or you can get away with one bill. definition I'm after now. I use a broader heat. Usually got to kind of tease the whole area to get to the same heat. This is what I get. More or less a final move on pushes once I pushed it out to the largest area I wanted to go to, then I kind of regather, let it get a little heat base to it. But it shapes out much smoother the second time. So I'm actually going to bring both edges of the nose down a little more now. They kind of tease the heat all around and identify it really sharp in those areas. I'm sorry, I'm probably not even the best idea.
That's not
the saying, keep a stiff upper lip. It's been on my mind a lot lately. So that's the part that collapses on this the most. Is like, I created this definition that's more or less the middle of the mouth, or if not the top lip. But through the process of shaping these, that's one of the things I think I'll show you, like try to show the most with the knife, is that getting just the right angle on that helps identify the upper lip, and to keep it chilled ahead of time, to keep a nice stiff upper lip, and you also build the facial character. So I don't want to drag on too much. You can see this is shaping up quite a bit. Next thing I would do is get more involved with chilling both sides of the nose. The silver strike is so neat because you can see your impact just immediately. Let's see. Get into this though, it kind of turns into two steps. The next thing I'm doing, I'm shaping the nose, and while that's cooling and I'm heating, I start shaping the eyebrows out. And both of those two steps turn into like a little bit lengthier. I think I can push on with that. My goal actually is to start carving and show you what it looks like to kick in and just cut into the glass. I could come back later, or I'll be working on these throughout the week. But here, it's a really neat form. It comes off the back, and it, I'm coming almost like out of the back corner with the ear, but because it's pushed out quite a bit and then formed to this angle, I get it to stand straight off the piece quite a bit. So I think it's a fun point to kind of take a pause and grab the other piece out of the kiln. He's got a pretty cool defined nose. It's a, like I say, a bit of a button nose. The goal when I pull the other piece out is first going to be to cut this lip right in about the middle. I'm going to do some definition around the nose, cheeks, and get into the eyes. It's pretty cool. trick with the surface carving is like to get it hot, real, real sharp on one area and carve quick. It's all about just penetrating the exact space you're going to hit with the knife.
Nobody can hear me.
half lit. You see you stick it with me. I know some of it's fast, but it's not fast at all. But try not to be over it. It's all the flame in the light. I mean, it helps, but there's a really good point to talk about. Like, I've been heating all this just through the area that I'm working in. So some steps I'll flame the needle more often than not. But this at least doesn't need that tedious step constantly. So with this one, I'm feeling that I'm just gonna do a light, nice light curved line toward the top of the eyebrow, or just kind of closed eye. And then more importantly, I think what you'll like to see is how I'm gonna carve out the ear. If you wanna check out any of these again, like the whole ear appears to be an added bit. I'm gonna cut into the back of it quite a bit. It ends up making it stand off the piece quite a bit. I like it because it would be near impossible to make a weld like that, but it sure does look like it was a separate component. I got a really fairly identified eyebrow set up there. I chilled the top, I pushed this up a bit. I'm gonna do the same here. Thank you. wore out when I had it onto a piece. Open a collab on things, you know, if you guys want to talk about collabs, it's sweet. Some of the heat and some of the flame in the alley is almost over. This silver stone, 3 and 5. Just such a beautiful color. So you got really neat identified detail around the mouth. The cheeks and lines are there. Gotta be real distinct. One thing I really like about getting that upper lip shaped is, you know, the mouth all together. So you can create an expression there. You can, you know, you really dig in deep enough to where the lips can have suggestion in different forms. So you can obviously see, like, you can elaborate on that quite a bit with eyeballs and, you know, tentacles. I'm gonna put tentacles on everything. But I want to express what I see as a beginning, finished piece, and a whole world of potential with the sculpting. That's all hollow in that nose, and it's super stable. I brought these up cold, I brought them up and just, you know, worked on them forever. Like, so even in the ear, like, you know, granted, sometimes I can see better and really get into, like, detailing inside the ear. It doesn't touch itself, but it is all potted and pickled there. And a lot of the times the noses, I'll push those up toward the end of when I'm really done working with them. That's a little bit of stress for sure. So I think that's a neat part of it. There's very little stress there. These two ears, we're at home in a little more, you know, comfortable environment. You can still see them more than this one, where they're almost separated from the piece, or cut off of it so much that they have their own definition. So I feel like it's, you know, it's an exciting direction. I'm having a lot of fun. Yeah, this is where I left off too, so with the shaped one. And really, that's a lot of the detail is there. It's another 20 minutes to a half an hour to really get it right. But like I say, I would go to the eyebrows next and use some of that heat to, like, do a little pre-shape on the ear and then back to the eyebrow. And at least that helps keep it all moving along. In other words, like, if I was doing this eyebrow, I would use the flame splash to come over and hit this ear. I want to do that ear, that would just end up being a whole pushed out area. But yeah, I would do this eyebrow, and while that chilled out heat here, I'd just kind of start moving that at the same time. A lot of juggling.